missing Rick. There he is.
Rick. Welcome, everybody. Start with the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome, everybody. Roll call.
Mr. Bell.
Here.
Mr. Katara.
Here.
Mr. Kraus.
Here.
Mrs. Meany.
Here.
Mr. Pedicino.
Here.
Mr. Balunas.
Here.
Mr. Russo.
Here. All right, I do not believe we have any changes to the agenda. Just the announcements are as read. Just a couple things to note. The Planning Commission originally was scheduled to meet on the 15th, but in observance of the Passover holiday, Planning Commission will be meeting on the 17th of April. City Hall will be closed on the 18th for Good Friday, and I believe, and everything else is as read. So it brings us to comments from the audience. Any comments from the audience? Going once, going twice, all right. We have one set of minutes from March 17th.
Move to approve.
Councilman Bell, Councilman Pedicino, any discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right. We have several items under pending. Item one.
Ordinance number 2014-37 and ordinance amending section 260.02B of the Administration Code types of employees. This is the third reading.
All right. Nancy?
Yes, this was something that had been discussed originally in the Finance Committee, and it just kind of defines types of employees. So I'll make a motion to approve ordinance number 2014-37, amending section 260.02B of the Administration Code types of employees.
Councilman, motion by Councilwoman Meany.
Second.
Second by Councilman Palunas. Any discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Item two.
Ordinance number 2014-38 and ordinance amending section 260.13C of the Administration Code commercial driver's license bonus. And this is the third reading.
Phil?
Yeah, seeing that how this is the third reading, and this also did come out of finance, and make a motion to approve ordinance number 2014-38, amending section 260.13, section C of the Administrative Code, commercial driver's license bonus.
Councilman Russo, second by Councilman Bell. Any further discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Okay, item three.
Resolution number 2014-39, a resolution accepting the final draft of the administrative purchasing procedures and declaring an emergency. This is the third reading, and this would be approved under as amended.
In an overabundance of caution, can you waive the three reading rule and then move to it to adopt because of the revision?
Sure.
Okay.
Sure. That's the way to incorporate the revision.
Correct.
Okay.
An overabundance of caution.
Okay. Nancy.
Okay. This came out of the Finance Committee, and I'll make a motion to approve resolution number 2014-39.
Why don't we, let's do the waiving.
As suspended.
Okay.
Waiving the three readings based upon the
amendment
of 1E.
Correct.
So make a motion as suspended. To approve resolution number
under suspension.
Okay, 2014 and accepting the final draft of the administrative purchasing procedures and as amended declaring an emergency.
Right.
This will be the waiving of the three readings.
Correct.
Based upon 1E. All right, motion by Councilman Meany, second by Councilman Palunas. Any discussion? Yeah.
Yeah, I would like to, I had this held at the last meeting, I asked for this to be held so I could have some questions asked. I'd like to just thank Mr. Kennedy for taking the time to go over all the questions that I had on the proposal, especially the ones that benefit some of the local businesses and some of the other questions that I had. So I'd like to thank Mr. Kennedy for his time in going over that with me.
So we got a motion and a second. This is roll call under suspension, that's all.
Okay, Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right. Nancy, then now we'll do a, now we need a motion to adopt.
Okay, I'll make a motion to adopt resolution number 2014-39, accepting the final draft of the administrative purchasing procedures as amended and declaring an emergency.
Councilwoman Meany, second by Councilman Russo. Any further discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Item four.
Ordinance number 2014-49, and ordinance authorizing the implementation of a fully automated citywide recycling program, and this is the second reading.
Okay. Tom, based upon the framework, we're going to keep this on second reading, and then we can, we have enough time to keep it on, and so we can have a third reading of this?
Yes.
Thank you. All right, we'll keep this on second reading. Any comments from anybody? Okay. All right, item five.
Ordinance number 2014-50, and ordinance authorizing the finance director to request proposals for professional traffic engineering services, and this is the second reading.
Okay, we had discussions during our caucus that this has been resolved, so Bill, you're going to make a motion?
Yeah, I'll make a motion that we reject ordinance number 2014-50, authorizing the finance director to request proposal for professional traffic engineering services.
Okay, motion by Councilman Russo, second by Councilman Pedicino. Any discussion on the motion to reject? Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right. We have one item under new, item six.
Ordinance number 2014-64, an ordinance providing for pay adjustment and pay schedule for full-time city employees not covered by a collective bargaining agreement for the year 2014 and declaring an emergency.
Bill.
Sure. This is for eligible employees for pay increases not to exceed 2.25% for 2014, provided such increase does not exceed the maximum pay indicated on the current wage schedule, and this shall be retroactive to January 1st, 2014. I'd like to make a motion that we pass this under emergency.
So this will be under suspension?
Under suspension.
All right. Councilman Russo, second by Councilman Meany. Any discussion? All right, roll call under suspension.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Final passage.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right. Thank you. We got a few items of correspondence. First off, item number seven.
A rezoning request from Ronald Kluchin, Architects Incorporated, representing the Fountains of Solon for property located at the intersection of Solon Road and Errico Drive.
Okay, it's my understanding that this will be referred to the Planning Commission. Before, Bob, before you referred it, I think Mark wanted to make a comment.
Yes, I did. Mr. Vice Mayor, thank you. I wanted to express that I have concerns about rezoning. I think that our zoning has been critical in helping to make Solon one of the best communities in the United States. And I think that we need to be prudent and not quick to alter what has been so essential in our success. And I just wanted to express that I will be expressing my concerns as well as the concerns of my constituents to the Planning Commission.
Thank you. All right, with that, Bob?
I will move to refer the rezoning request from Ronald Kluchin, Architects Incorporated, representing the Fountains of Solon to the Planning Commission for discussion purposes.
Thank you. Motion by Councilman Plunis, second by Councilman Pedicino. Any discussion? Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Plunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right, thank you. All right, item eight.
Item eight is a request from the mayor to declare a safety and sports gear expo and 5K for wellness event as a public purpose.
All right, Bill?
Sure. This is an event that would take place on Sunday, April 27th from 8:30 to a.m. to 1 p.m. It's a joint venture between University Hospitals and the City of Solon, and it's to promote health and wellness throughout the community. I'd like to make a motion that we approve the Safety and Sports Gear Expo and 5K for Wellness as event as a public purpose.
Motion by Councilman Russo, second by Councilman Bell. Any discussion? Look forward to seeing everyone there. Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Plunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right, item nine.
Okay. I thought you were going to ask for comments, and I thought the chiefs might be saying something.
Okay.
Okay.
Moving right along, right?
Nine.
Okay. A request from the Relay for Life Committee for authorization to include the City of Solon logo on T-shirts used as a fundraiser for the Relay for Life event.
Nancy.
Yes. Team Solon has decided to sell T-shirts as their main fundraiser for participating in the Relay for Life. So I'm going to make a motion to allow Team Solon to use the Solon logo on their T-shirts for the Relay for Life race.
This is for city employees.
City employees, yes.
The employees are Team Solon.
Right.
They're selling the T-shirts as their main fundraiser
right.
at Relay,
okay.
But this other people could buy the
T-shirt. Right.
Okay.
I just want to, okay. Councilwoman Meany, second by Councilman Russo. Any just further discussion? All right, roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Excuse me. Mr. Katura?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Plunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right, it brings us to our consent agenda. Seems that no one has to remove anything, so we'll start with item 10.
Ordinance number 2014-65, an ordinance authorizing the purchase of equipment and wear from Acushnet, FootJoy, and Titleist to be resold at the Grantwood Golf Course Pro Shop.
Nancy.
Okay, well, I guess a good thing it's that time of year, springtime, if we're buying stuff for Grantwood. This is for the purchase from FootJoy and Titleist in the amount of $20,000, and for Titleist, $12,000. And for a total of $32,000 for equipment and wear to be resold at the Grantwood Golf Course Pro Shop.
Item 11.
Ordinance number 2014-66, an ordinance authorizing a discounted membership to the Solon Community Center for city employees who are actively participating in the Be Well Solutions Employee Wellness Program.
Mark.
This legislation authorizes a discounted membership to the Solon Community Center for those city employees who are actively participating in the Be Well Solutions Employee Wellness Program.
Item 12.
Ordinance number 2014-67, a resolution accepting a letter of arrangement from the Auditor of State of Ohio for audit services and declaring an emergency.
Bill.
Sure, this is for professional services in the amount of $34,235.
Item 13.
Ordinance number 2014-68, an ordinance authorizing payment to Dakin Applied Americas Incorporated for additional HVAC services at the Water Reclamation Department.
Nancy.
Yes, McKay Services was purchased by Dakin Applied Americas. Therefore, we need to provide payment to Dakin Applied Americas in the amount of $4,625 for HVAC services at the Water Rec Department.
Item 14.
Ordinance number 2014-69, an ordinance authorizing the mayor to execute a one-year renewable contract with Burgess and Nipel for general engineering design services and amending ordinance number 2014-2. To authorize the contract for the years 2014 and 2015.
Rick.
There was a request for proposals for general engineering design services. Nine firms responded with qualifications, and a selection committee reviewed the qualification. Burgess and Nyepel was ranked as the most qualified to develop plans and specifications for general engineering design services.
Item 15.
Ordinance number 2014-70, and ordinance authorizing the renewal of the on-site supplemental construction inspection services contract with GPD Group.
Mark.
This legislation renews the current on-site inspection services contract 2013.02 with GPD Group for one additional year ending May 31st, 2015. It reappropriates the unused funds from the first year of the contract and adds an additional $350,000, which has been planned for, and includes additional clearly defined language regarding inspector responsibilities.
Item 16.
Ordinance number 2014-71, and ordinance amending ordinance number 2013-9, which accepted the proposal of Euthenics Incorporated for professional design services for the Somme Center Road, Aurora Road intersection improvement project.
Nancy.
Yes, it was found during the road widening for the improvement project, the electrical systems that are used for the holiday lighting will need to be relocated. Therefore, the engineering department recommended that Euthenics, they quoted a price of $15,947.46. So that would be to amend the current contract and add $15,947.46 to that contract.
Item 17.
Ordinance number 2014-72. An ordinance authorizing the mayor to enter into an agreement with the Ohio EPA Clean Water Act Section 319H to accept a grant to fund the St. Mary's Stream Bank Restoration Project.
Rick.
With this ordinance, we will be authorizing the mayor to accept a grant to fund the St. Mary's Stream Bank Restoration Project in the amount of $105,660. And the city of Solon will provide the necessary matching funds of $70,440.
18.
Ordinance number 2014-73, and ordinance approving change order number 7 to the contract with Mr. Excavator for the Briar Hill Lake Dam Project.
Mark.
Because of concerns that the drainage was not working as well as it should be at the Briar Hill Lake Dam Project, the city instructed the contractor to remove a construction road, regrade the area to drain, and seed the newly graded area. The contractor performed the layout, excavation and grading at his own cost, while the city agreed to pay for the mobilization of the excavating equipment, topsoil, seeding. The total additional cost was $4,907.43. This legislation also amends the contract language to allow for 75% of the retainage to be released upon substantial completion of the project.
Item 19.
Ordinance number 2014-74. And ordinance accepting the final contract adjustment with Trimore Corporation for the Davis Industrial Parkway Concrete Repair Project.
Nancy.
Yes, this is a final change order for the Davis Industrial Parkway Concrete Repair Project. The original contract amount was $282,585. To close out the contract, the amount is $239,789.61, and this will be paid to the Trimore Corporation.
Item 20.
Ordinance number 2014-75, and ordinance accepting the bid of Trimore Corporation for the 2014 annual concrete pavement repair program.
There were five bidders. The bid of Trimore Corporation for the 2014 annual concrete pavement repair program in the amount of $2,075,548 was the lowest and the best bid.
21.
Ordinance number 2014-76, and ordinance accepting the donation of 500 printed reusable grocery bags from Giant Eagle Market District to promote the city stormwater theme, Only Rain in the Drain.
Mark.
This is legislation that allows the city of Solon to accept a donation from Giant Eagle for 500 reusable grocery bags. the purpose of which is to help promote the public education of the city's stormwater management plan. The shopping bags will have the city's only Rain in the Drain logo imprinted on one side and Giant Eagle logo printed on the other side. The approximate retail value of this donation is $1,000.
Item 22.
Ordinance number 2014-77, and ordinance approving change order 4 to the contract with Parham Electric for the citywide traffic signal improvement project.
Nancy.
Yes, as part of the citywide traffic signal improvement project, part of what is being done is the installation of fiber optic cables. Our IT department came forward and thought it would be a good idea if the city kind of increased this number so that we could really end up covering the city ourselves. And so to do this, we're going to need to add, to amend the change order in the amount of $24,977.63.
Item 23.
Resolution number 2014-78, a resolution authorizing the Director of City Services to provide an estimate and enter into contracts with the Ohio Department of Transportation for the purchase of sodium chloride for the 2014-2015 winter season through the state purchasing contract and declaring an emergency.
Rick.
Although pricing confirmation has not yet been determined for the 2014-2015 winter season, ODOT requires an estimate of the rock salt purchases for this winter season, and that needs to be provided by April 8th to participate in the Ohio Cooperative Purchasing Program.
Item 24.
Ordinance number 2014-79, and ordinance accepting the final contract adjustment with Aaron Landscaping Incorporated for the Pettibone Road Restoration Project.
Mark.
This is the final change order to the Pettibone Road Restoration Project contract 2012.19. This change order reduces the contract by $11,107.98, since not all of the estimated quantities were used, and it closes the contract out in the amount of $78,914.52.
Item 25.
Ordinance number 2014-80, and ordinance authorizing the Finance Director and the Water Reclamation Director to request qualifications for engineering services for their preliminary treatment improvement feasibility study.
Nancy.
Yes, this was discussed at our last Public Works Committee, and we have a lot of equipment and technology at the plant that are well over 35 years old, and we thought it was prudent to allow for a study to be done to, you know, see what kind of recommendations and cost projections may be available to improve the treatment and flow at the water rec.
26.
Ordinance number 2014-81, and ordinance accepting the bid of Fabrizi Trucking and Paving for the Hunter's Ridge Improvement Project.
Rick.
There were 4 sealed bids that we received for the Hunter's Ridge Infrastructure Improvements Project. The base bid that was submitted by Fabrizi Trucking and Paving in the amount of $1,414,377.00 was the lowest and the best bid.
27.
Ordinance number 2014-82, and ordinance accepting the base bid of Bob Coltrona Landscaping for the 2014 lawn maintenance contract.
Mark.
On March 28, 2014, 3 sealed bids were opened for the 2014 lawn maintenance contract for various city properties. Bob Coltrona Landscaping was the lowest responsive and responsible bidder in the amount of $40,125. Bob Coltrona Landscaping has been in business for over 40 years and has performed these services for the city of Solon with favorable results in the past.
28.
Ordinance number 2014-83, and ordinance accepting the bids of Allied Corporation, Arms Trucking, Erie Materials, Ontario Stone Corp, and 3Z Supply for the purchase of asphalt products, crushed limestone and stone, sand, topsoil, mulch, and related products for the use by the Service Department for 2014 and declaring an emergency.
Nancy.
Yes, there were actually 7 companies that bid on this, and we accepted the lowest and most responsible bids for the following companies: Allied Corporation, Arms Trucking, Erie Materials, Ontario Stone Corporation, and 3Z Supply.
Okay, brings us to the end of consent agenda. There a motion?
Motion approved consent agenda under suspension.
Moniz, second by Councilman Meany. Any discussion? Roll call under suspension.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis? Mr. Russo?
Yes.
Final passage.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katara?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mrs. Meany?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunis?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.
All right, brings us to the end of our agenda. Brings us to comments from the audience. Any comments from the audience? Going once, going twice. All right, brings us back to the table. Bob?
I have no comments this evening.
Nancy?
Just want to wish everyone a happy Passover and Easter, and also since hopefully we're getting to the time of year where people are going to start cleaning their lawns up, I just want to remind everybody to please, like, put your bags out when it's your day to have it picked up, just as a courtesy to your neighbors and just, you know, the appearance of the city in a whole. And I assume, Tom, that the bags can go out now, that you guys will be picking up the brown bags, as I call them?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, and that's it.
Jeff?
No comment.
Mark?
As many of you may know, there was a fire in Ward 4 about 10 days ago, and it was less than optimal conditions to be fighting a fire. There was a lot of snow and cold that the old man winter just doesn't want to let go this year. Hopefully we're through it now. And I wanted to, again, express my sincere gratitude to the police and especially the fire forces for handling that in such an efficient manner. Fortunately, there were no injuries. And I hope that the chief will make some comments on that as well.
Rick?
No comments this evening.
Bill?
Sure. I'd like to thank the mayor and her husband for attending the Easter egg stuffing on Friday night. This is going to be the 30th annual egg hunt in Solon. And in recognition of that, the Italian Club, instead of stuffing 10,000 eggs, stuffed 15,000 eggs and did it in about an hour. Had over 60 volunteers. So, again, thank you, Mayor, for attending. And look forward to seeing everybody. There is one change. The Easter egg hunt will be on Saturday, April 19th, and a new start time at 10 o'clock rather than noon. So again, if you attend at noon, you'll be way too late.
All right. Thank you, Bill. I just, a couple comments. I normally don't comment about newspaper articles, but there were two that struck my attention. I felt compelled to comment, one being an article in The Sun regarding our really ability to get all of our meetings out on time, on a timely basis, and advertising everything that we do, both the committee and council. I thought that it really highlighted the thing that really we do very well, and that's the ability to be transparent in our city government and really giving our citizens the opportunity to comment about everything we do, giving them a lot of leg time and leeway to be able to comment upon the various issues before us. And a lot of it makes us look good, but a lot of it has to do with Carol and what Carol does and her staff. They really make us look good by putting together, and we talk on the days that a lot of these things go out. And Carol and her staff really have a lot of work to do, but they're the ones that really bring this to the attention of the public and really go with our mantra of being as transparent as possible. And I know that we do a heck of a job in making sure we get that out. So thank you for the correspondence as well. And then the other article that came to my attention was in the Times regarding our economic development and what we do in our community. In particular, it was highlighted our ability to take some of our older properties and our older buildings that really have an outdated use and be able to work with our businesses and bring in businesses to come in and retrofit those buildings. And a lot of work and a lot of effort
The article mentioned the mayor and the administration, and in particular Peggy, and the work that she does in bringing in these companies, because a lot of these buildings have no use anymore, and Peggy's able to work with existing businesses in Solon and businesses that are outside of Solon to be able to come in and have a vision of what to do with these older businesses. And there's a lot of issues regarding electricity and all of the issues that they have to retrofit to make it a modern and a viable business. And it's something that obviously we take a lot of pride in making sure that we have the space for those companies that are here in Solon and want to relocate, as well as companies that are looking to Solon to make it a home. So I really enjoyed reading that article as well, and making us understand all the efforts and the great work that we do in making this the premier business destination in Northeastern Ohio. So I just had a comment upon those two articles. And lastly, happy Passover, happy Easter to everybody in the community. It's a great time to celebrate and be with family and friends. With that, comments from the administration, starting with the mayor.
Just a couple comments tonight. First one is, on Thursday, April 3rd, we celebrated the grand opening and the ribbon cutting for Advanced Auto Parts. They are now located in Solon Square, so we welcome them to the Solon community and wish them much success. And secondly, this Friday, April 11th, the Solon Center for the Arts will be hosting the 9th annual Focus event. That will be held at the Community Center between 6 and 8 p.m. This event is free, so please come and enjoy. And finally, I just want to say happy Passover to all who will be celebrating. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor.
No comments. Tom?
Carol?
No comments.
Well, thank you for the comments.
Welcome.
That's
Chief?
It.
Nothing tonight. Thank you.
Chief?
Add on to what Mr. Katora had mentioned, we did have a fire on Saturday, March 29th on Maple Drive. I want to commend A-Shift and particularly Battalion Chief Joe Stoneberg, who did an excellent job. It was a great team effort under some very trying conditions due to the weather and some of the building construction issues. We did request mutual aid for this fire, some of which was not available, but I do want to give a tip of the hat to the Aurora Fire Department. They handled an ambulance call for us while we were handling the fire. Currently, the fire is under investigation, and we should be concluded pretty soon. However, I do want to thank all the residents on Maple Drive who have provided us information regarding this incident. It's been very, very helpful. To echo what Ms. Meany was mentioning with the spring cleanup that hopefully everyone gets into, I just want to remind everyone that it is illegal to burn brush and material like that. We have a great service department who will come and pick that material up. So if you have an issue with that, a large amount or whatever, I'm sure if you call them, they'll be able to accommodate you. Thank you.
Dan?
Nothing this evening.
Paul?
Nothing this evening.
Mr. Bandier?
No comments. Thank you.
Slow night. John?
Nothing this evening. Thank you.
Peggy? Okay. Lobey promised us no executive session, and actually he delivered on this. So, motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Councilman Russo, Secretary Councilman Flunas. Roll call.
Mr. Bell?
Yes.
Mr. Katora?
Yes.
Mr. Kraus?
Yes.
Mr. Pedicino?
Yes.
Mr. Palunas?
Yes.
Mr. Russo?
Yes.